Hello dear students, in this video we are going to discuss the exercise questions and their answers of the first chapter, that is matter. Before that, let's have a recap of the lesson. Matter is anything that has mass, occupies space and can be perceived by our senses. Matter consists of tiny particles called atoms and molecules. There is an intermolecular force of attraction between the particles of matter. The gaps between the particles are called intermolecular spaces. Particles of matter are always in random motion and they collide with each other. Matter exists in three states: solids, liquids, and gases. Matter can change from one state to another when temperature and pressure are changed. The phenomenon of change of one state of matter into another and vice versa is called interconversion of states of matter. Matter can neither be created nor be destroyed. Only it can be changed from one form to another. Exercise. Question number 1. Define matter. Answer. Matter is anything which has mass, occupies space, and can be perceived by our senses. Example. Air. Book. B. Define intermolecular force of attraction. The molecules of matter are always in motion and attract each other with a force called intermolecular force of attraction, due to which they are held together. Question number 2. What are the three states of matter? Define each of them with two examples. Answer. The three states of matter are solids, liquids, and gases. Solids. A solid has a definite shape and definite volume. Example. Wood, stone, iron, ice, etc. Liquid. A liquid has a definite volume but not definite shape. Example, water, juice, milk, oil, etc. Gases. A gas neither has definite shape nor a definite volume. Example, air, hydrogen, oxygen, water vapor, etc. Question number 3. Define interconversion of states of matter. What are the two factors responsible for the change of state of matter? Answer, the process by which matter changes from one state to another and back to original state without any change in its chemical composition is called interconversion of states of matter. Two factors responsible for change of state of matter are change in temperature and change in pressure. Question number 4. State the main postulates of kinetic theory of matter. Answer. The main postulates of the theory are, first one, matter is composed of very small particles called atoms and molecules. 2. The constituent particles of a kind of matter are identical in all respects. 3. These particles have space or gaps between them, which is known as interparticular or intermolecular space. 4. There exists a force of attraction between the particles of matter, which holds them together. This force of attraction is known as interparticular or intermolecular force of attraction. 5. Particles of matter are always in a state of random motion and possess kinetic energy, which increases with increase in temperature and vice versa. Question number 5. What happens to water if it is kept in a deep freezer? Answer. When water is kept in a deep freezer, it gets cooled and changed into ice at 0 degrees Celsius. B. What happens to water if it is heated? Answer. Water on heating changes into steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Phenomenon of change of state of water. Water is a liquid under ordinary conditions, but when it is kept in a deep freezer, it changes into ice at 0 degrees Celsius. And when ice is kept at room temperature, again changes back into liquid water. Similarly, water on heating changes into steam at 100 degrees Celsius, which on cooling changes back into liquid water. But there is no change in the chemical composition of water when its state changes from liquid to solid or liquid to gaseous state. Question number 6. State the law of conservation of mass. Answer. Matter can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. However, it may change from one form to another in the process. It can also be stated as, in a chemical reaction, the total mass of the reactants is equal to the total mass of the products. B. What do you observe when barium chloride solution is mixed with sodium sulfate solution? We will observe that a white insoluble solid, that is precipitate of barium sulfate, is formed along with a solution of sodium chloride. Wait for 10 minutes to complete the reaction and the solid form to settle down. Weigh the content again and note the reading. We will observe that total mass of the apparatus plus reactants is equal to total mass of the apparatus plus products. Hence, the law of conservation of mass is verified. Question number 7. Give reason. A gas can fill the whole vessel in which it is enclosed. Answer. Because in gases, the molecules are free to move. They are not stuck to each other and the intermolecular force of attraction is least in the gases. So, the gas almost fills the whole vessel in which it is enclosed. Question number B. Solids cannot be compressed. The reason is, in solids, particles are closely packed. There is a strong force of attraction and the intermolecular space is almost zero. Therefore, the molecules are not free to move, which makes them hard and rigid. So, solids cannot be compressed. See, liquids can flow. The reason is, in liquids, intermolecular force is weaker because the particles are not closely packed and hence there is large intermolecular space. So, molecules in liquids can move randomly and hence liquids can flow easily. D. When magnesium is burnt in air, there is an increase in mass after the reaction. The answer is, when magnesium ribbon is burnt in air, a white solid, magnesium oxide, is formed. The mass of magnesium oxide is more than the mass of magnesium. This is because mass of oxygen used is not taken. If that is considered, the total mass of the reactants and the products is found to be almost equal. Question number 8. Fill in the blanks. A. The change of a solid into a liquid is called melting or fusion. B. The process in which a solid directly changes into a gas is called sublimation. C. The change of water vapor into water is called condensation. D. The temperature at which a liquid starts changing into its vapor state is evaporation or vaporization. Question number 9. Give two examples for each of the following. A. The substances which sublime. Answer: camphor, iodine, naphthalene, ammonium chloride, dry ice, that is solid carbon dioxide, etc. B. The substances which do not change their state on heating. Answer: the gases do not change their state on heating. Example: oxygen and helium. Question number 10. Define diffusion. The intermixing of two or more substances due to the motion of their particles in order to get a uniform mixture is called diffusion. B. Brownian motion. The haphazard random motion of suspended particles on the surface of a liquid or in air is called Brownian motion. Question number 11. When sodium chloride is added to a definite volume of water and stirred well, a solution is formed, but there is no increase in the level of water. Why? Answer: this is because there is some space between the particles of water in which the salt particles get accommodated when dissolved. Question number 12. What do you observe when a gas jar which appears empty is inverted over a gas jar containing bromine vapors? Name the phenomenon. Answer: when a gas jar full of bromine vapors, which is in reddish brown color, is inverted over a gas jar containing air over it, it is observed that after some time, the reddish brown vapors of bromine also spread out into the upper jar. This mixing is called diffusion. The rate of diffusion is the fastest in gases and the slowest in solids. It increases with an increase in temperature. Question number 13. Why can a piece of chalk be broken easily into small pieces while a cold piece cannot be broken easily? Answer. The particles of matter have force acting between them. This force keeps the particles together. The strength of this force of attraction is lesser in chalk, hence it could be broken easily into smaller pieces. But the strength of intermolecular force of attraction is very strong in coal. Therefore, it is not possible to break them into small pieces. Dear students, write all these questions and their answers in your notebook and learn them. Click on the links provided in the description box to watch part 1 to 3 of the chapter 1, Matter. And also subscribe the channel to get more videos. Thank you.